again. This is where we were. If I write it in, since I have the trigonometric function using the Euler's identity in exponent form, I can easily see that I have here x of minus 7 equals x of minus 3 equals x of minus plus 3 equals x of 7 equals 0.5. The rest equals 0. We can easily find the Fourier series coefficient of the trigonometric signals. But I think I was trying to make some points and asking you to find this using a Laplace transformation or something. I'm not so sure about this problem. But if this is the case, if I ask you to find the signal x of t is equal to cosine 3t plus sine 7t using Laplace, then we have to look at the evaluation of s is equal to j omega 0 k term. Is it in rock? This is important. And we were trying to find out for this approaches x1 of t is equal to x of t times u of t minus u of t minus t0. We get the single period of the signal and we call it x1 of t. And I'm supposed to find this x sub k 1 over t0 Laplace transformation of x1 of t or 1 over t0 x1 of s. S is evaluated if it can j omega 0 k. However, anybody remembers what is the rock for cosine function? Cosine times u of t. Real part of s positive. Does it include j omega? Anybody? Mm-hmm. Oh, we have more students. By the way, if you want to answer this answer after that, I'd like you to sign up. Just write in the chat window of your ID numbers. We are collecting them. The answer is no. Real part of S is greater than zero. It doesn't include j omega axis. So you have this region on S plane. So this axis is j omega 0 case will not be included inside the rock. So we shouldn't be using Laplace transformation when we make the S evaluated at certain frequencies. That's not in the region of convergence, okay? Don't go that trap. If it is asked, I just want you to answer. No, it cannot be, it shouldn't be done using Laplace transformation. All right. What else I have? Let me see. As a question. So we are given in 4.2 synthesis. We are saying that let omega 0 equals 4 radian per second, and we have the coefficient for Fourier series coefficient. C0 is equal to 2, C1 is equal to 5, C minus 2 is equal to 0.6 exponent minus j pi over 3. C2 is equal to 0.6 exponent plus j pi over 3. And the rest are 0. All the other coefficient, Fourier series coefficient of the signal is 0. What is the signal? By Fourier series definitions, you are going to have C0 plus C1 exponent j omega 0, which is 4t, plus C minus 2 exponent minus j 2 times omega 0 t, which is 8t, plus C2 exponent j 8t, 0, 1, minus 2, plus 2. This is how we get this answer. So if you substitute these coefficients, I would have here 2 plus 5 exponent j 4t and plus 0.6 exponent minus j 8t plus pi over 3 and plus exponent plus j 8t plus pi over 3. Is it right? And okay. So I can go one step further, get this 1.2 times cosine 80 plus pi over 3. This would be my x of t signal synthesized through it is Fourier series coefficients. All right. I don't think this was part of the problem, so, but I just wanted to discuss it with you. Y of t is given as rectangle t over 4. I think I switched to Fourier series, Fourier transformation. Had the Fourier transformation of 4 sinc 2 omega. You play with this Fourier transformation pair, and you are asked to find out x of t is equal to a times rectangle t minus 2 over 4. I'm not so sure if the problem was given in this form. I have in my notes written that way. So when I compare this, I see that it is exactly a y of t minus 2. If you substitute t minus 2 in a y signal, you get this internal part and scaled by a. This is what you get. And using the linearity and time shift property, properties. Excuse me. This would be calculated without using the integral, just using the properties of the Fourier transformation. And in the third questions, you have given a signal of sine of t. As limit a goes to zero, when you send the a to zero, this signal on the right hand side converges to minus one plus one sine t signal. We were asked to find out the Fourier transformation of this signal first. This problem in the class notes were solved in the Fourier series discussion. So x of omega is equal to, this is the causal part, limit a goes to zero, I will have here 1 over s plus a minus 1 over minus s plus a. I am doing this Fourier transformation using Fourier using Laplace transformation. I need to write this down before I proceed. This was the equal to Laplace transformation of x of t, where s is evaluated at j omega. Of course, if j omega is covered by rock. All right, so s is evaluated minus j omega. Okay, there is another 2b. Okay, I'll look into that. And let's finish this one first. One over a plus j omega minus 1 over a minus j omega. If we sum them together, we get 2 j omega a square minus j square omega square plus omega square s limit a goes to zero as the answer, and this would be equal to 2j over omega would be the answer. Okay, now do I have a minus sign somewhere? Minus j omega minus j omega, sorry. 2 over j omega. You can make it plus by moving the j, multiplying both numerator and denominator by j. We get this negated value. And in the extension of this question, I'm checking my notes, representing a u of t. U of t now can be represented as 0.5 plus 0.5 of x of t. And then it is Fourier transformation u of omega. I have 0.5 using the 1 being 2 pi delta omega from the table, we get the constant Fourier transform plus 0.5 times x of omega, and linearity property is applied in here. So the unit step signals Fourier transformation, which cannot be found by integral definition because it's not absolutely integrable, which cannot be immediately found through the Laplace transformation since it is region of convergence does not include j omega axis. But we go with a kind of, we make a trick through the x of t signal or sine signal, we end up getting an answer which is pi times delta omega plus 1 over j omega, 2 times 0.5 is equal to 1. So we end up getting, remember u of s was 1 over s, at s is equal to j omega, you only get this part. But by going through this step, we end up, we've seen that in the true Fourier transformation of unit step signal, we have an additional term that can be computed in this way. Okay. The other question was, I think Merve said 2.B, which was solved. I think 2.A minus not shown here. And if this is the question, she was asking to find out the Fourier transformation of x of t is equal to a times sine omega 1t plus b times cosine omega 2t signal. And this was, I didn't want to go because it's kind of a conditional answer you are going to get here. First of all, assume that if x of t is periodic, then use Fourier series coefficient for Fourier transform. Else, if this is not a periodic, you know that this signal goes from minus infinity to plus infinity. If you get the absolute value of it and integrate it, you are going to see that x of t is not absolutely integrable. So you cannot solve it this way. Okay? Since I didn't give any numeric value and for omega 1 and omega 2, and you need to find out what is the omega 0 and t 0, and then find the Fourier series coefficient and end up getting this. It's just, I leave it as a discussion. This is not a good question to cover here. It is good just to think about the cases where you can, what kind of techniques you can apply to find the Fourier series discussion narratively. Okay. And in question 5.28, you are given and 200, 0.52. And this is the power of the signal F omega is given to you, and we also have 100, 300, 100, -300, and the values here are 16, 24 given to us. This is H of omega, omega given to us. And I think in the questions you are asked to find out power of the system output, Y omega, what is it? If F is applied to system of H omega as the input. And in terms of power ratio for this Py is equal to H omega square PF, or Y omega is equal to H omega times F omega. We could do it, sorry. If you are asked to find out the outputs, we would have written with H omega multiplication. But since we are asked to find out the power spectrum, not the magnitude, we are going to get the square of H omega. I think there is a question. All right. You're welcome. Now let's see what we are seeing here at PF. We have pulses at frequencies shown in here. So I need to find out what is the H of omega at this particular locations, at frequencies, omega. So I have omega here, H of omega here at -200 +200 -150 +150. These values needs to be calculated. When I look at the H of omega, it's a linear line, which is the slope of 24 minus 16 over 300 -100 times omega minus, if I pick the value of frequency 100, this value should be giving me 16. And since I have here on the left hand side the same picture, I'm just going to put here the absolute value of omega. When omega is +100 and or -100, it will give me the same value. Okay, so this is the equation that describes this H of omega. And when omega is equal to -200, I'm going to have here 8 over 200 times 200 minus 100 plus 16. So 420. So I'm going to put here 400. H of omega is equal to -200. H of 150 is equal to 8 over 200 50 plus 16. 400 divided by 200 plus 16, it gives me 18. And I have here 18 square. Therefore, Py will be equal to at minus 200, PF has value 0.5 times uh, 400. This value only will exist at the frequencies of minus 200 and plus 200. Plus, I have two more pulses will come here, which is both are in the range of here and here. So a value of 2 times 18 square of delta omega minus and plus I keep changing my omegas. Let me be consistent a little bit. Do I have another omegas? That's okay. So omega. This would be power spectrum of this system response. You can calculate these coefficients, and it will be you can just plot be underneath. Let me change the color here. You are going to have here this 150s. I have 200. I don't know which one is more. Probably. So these coefficients are given, for example, at 200. I'm going to have 200 value for Py of omega. Okay. Let's see. No questions. All right. This was the problem 5.28. And I have another question. I don't know if it's a question number 5 or something. We have x of t is equal to rectangle t over 2 or u of t plus 1 minus u of t minus 1 with the Fourier pair of x of omega given as 2 times sine omega over omega given. Using the Fourier transformation properties given by in the table 5.1 or 5.2, you need to find out the Fourier transformation of A. X1 of t is equal to minus u of t plus 2 plus u of t minus u of t minus 2. I have a feeling like I have solved this problem, but not so sure. So if you look at this u of t plus 1, I have here minus x of t plus 1 signal in here plus x of t minus 1. So x1 is rewritten in terms of x of t with some time operations. You end up getting this signal. Now, using the time shift and the linearity property, we can find of x1 omega. I have here minus x of omega shifted by 1s. Shifted by 1. So exponent j omega plus x of omega exponent minus j omega. And should we write these equations? What are the x omegas? I have here sine omega over omega twice exponent j minus exponent j omega. And I have the same angle, same phase in the exponent term, which is omega, and sine is negative. Therefore, if I divide this by 2j and multiply by 2j, I would get here sine of omega. This will be equal to 4j times sine of omega square over omega. The B part is saying that if x of 2 of t is given as 2 times sine t over t, can you find x 2 of omega without actually integrating this one? Going with integral definition to get this integral is going to be problematic. Complex terms will appear there. But using the Fourier transformation properties, we see, we try to find out a property that will help us. If I look at this definition of signal, it is actually x2 of t is equal to uppercase x of t, right? And using the duality, property, and x2 of omega will be equal to 2 pi of lowercase omega x minus omega, which is equal to 2 pi. What is x of t? It is given above as u of t plus 1 minus u of t minus 1. T will be substituted by minus omega plus 1 minus u of minus omega minus 1. We don't like to write the u of minus omega. We can look at this signal. This actually, let's do it in here. This part of u of minus omega plus t, it will be a signal starting from 1 to a negative section. It will be always 1. But I'm going to subtract here u of minus omega minus 1, which is omega is equal to minus 1. After that, I'm going to subtract the same value. So it will be just this single pulse. So this is x of 2 omega two pi u of omega plus one minus u of omega minus one it will be the same signal with the plus omegas are given. I think more of these signals X3 two times U of T plus 0.5 minus U of T minus 0.5. I wanted to make this similar to as a function of x. It's not in this form yet. So I can use this u of t property 2t plus 1 minus u of 2t minus 1. If you look at this signal 0.5 minus 0.5. And you are going to see same picture you get it here. You get the common parentheses of 2, and then this gives you equal signals. Now I can say that x of 3 is equal to 2 times x of 2t. Now we can use time scaling and linearity props properties to find out x3 omega, which is equal to 2 times 1 half of x of omega over